tell us how the vibe is between all the artists that participate in an event like this. Is this sort of like a collective for you guys? Do you feel as part of a collective?
Yeah, I mean, I just did an interview with Anthony from Red Hot Chili Peppers, yeah. who I've never met. And there's just a very good common feeling amongst us all, I think. Mm-hmm. You know, leave your egos at the door. The letters we were all sent just said, first, you know, it's going to be very difficult to organise. Please leave your egos at the door. And it's true, there's a pile of them as you go in.
Step over all these egos to get in.
It's good.
So what are the gigs that you're anxious to see today or?
I think we're kind of not going to see anything today because we're probably going to be working here backstage doing interviews and probably quite a few tomorrow, but we'd love to see Kraftwerk, wouldn't we?
Yes, me too.
How do you feel about the Beastie Boys and especially Adam's dedication to this cause?
Well, I think, you know, I don't think it's any particular secret that as a group we've always admired and respected the Beastie Boys, like doing stuff, you know, like the way they're an organisation. So, you know, we want to copy them, really. With my naked eyes.
Let me say, cynics at the back of the room, I would like to think that an event like this can bring about good change and not just people educating themselves and doing something about it individually, but maybe there's a possibility that our president, that our government would re-examine their priorities in terms of China and listen to the people that voted them into office.
Optimistic about the entire thing. Like how much impact do you think this is going to have, particularly this year being in Washington? Do you think we're going to see another one next year?
Well, as far as another concert next year, there's no way to. I'm sure there will, because Adam Yauch is a very committed individual, and until he gets satisfaction on this, he's not going to let up. Being in D.C., it's right in Bill Clinton's backyard. He's going to have to pay attention to this rally tomorrow, because there will be all these people. And they're not there for a rock show. They're there to show support for Tibet. Mm-hmm. And I think if he's a smart man, which he is, he'll pay attention to that. Do I think that there will be a resolution of this year? No, I don't, but it's the beginning.
I
About REM's involvement over the years in many, many different causes and issues. Do you feel that maybe you, if I could say, spread the example over to other bands to get involved? It seems like in the 90s, a lot of bands are getting involved with different issues.
Well, I would hope so. I certainly can't claim to know exactly how much influence we've had on other people, but musicians, by and large, if they achieve any sort of success at all, they're very lucky people. They get to make a living doing what they really enjoy. And I think it's incumbent on people who have that good fortune to pass that along to other people. And if you're given the opportunity to rally support for what's obviously a very strong cause, the freedom of Tibet, then you have to take that opportunity. We do that. We don't want to trivialize by taking on too many causes, but you pick the ones that are most important and try to energize the youth of America or of Canada to do something about it. Because you know, if young people are not involved, then whatever support there is for an issue will die. You know, it has to begin again with every new generation of young people, and that's what we try to do.
If you believe, there's nothing up my sleeve. Thank you very much.